This is the first time I've been for a bottle dig in a long time, so dug this out before, but gonna give it another crack. We're getting to the deeper layers, and like just sitting on the surface is the Parramatta cod bottle, stoneware bottle. If you look around, we're in the right era of it all. There's writing on it. I don't know. There you go. Broken cod bottle there. Yeah, part of a broken cod bottle. There's a few here. So we'll start digging soon and I'll set the camera up and yeah, I'll have a dig, prepare myself.
Yeah, it looks like
it.
Oh shit, that was.
It was sitting in the dirt like that, the bum was up.
It's gonna get purple.
Purple patch.
Yeah, you're a purple patch. Ooh, yes! Yeah, baby. Full bottle. Look at that.
Maybe.
Oh, she bought me, man.
There.
I've got a few of them on me. That's the blue bottle I just found. Perfect little. I guess that's the poison or something. Look at that. That's hectic, eh? And Pete just found a blank lid. Pete's already got some hidden stash bottles. We found this little Rogers and Gallery. Oh. In Paris. And that's going to go purple, that bottle.
Right. This is his little trench he's making. I'll show you some of the broken bottles that he's found. A lot of local Campbelltown bottles. That's a Campbelltown cod. Look, Summons and Graham. I meant Summons and Graham, I meant JP Sutton. Another JP Sutton. Another one. Yeah, a whole stack of broken cod, so we're in the right era. And what's that one? No idea. But yeah, he's cod pretty big. Let's hopefully pull some big ones out of there. Full ones, I should say, some big ones.
All of that. Nah, it doesn't work. I need a chicken. Oh, look at this! Look at this! Something that you don't find in...
What is it, a yo-yo?
Yeah. Oh, that is sick, eh? Look at that. That is sick. Like these little ants there. I'm just talking on the camera, bro. These little ants here are vicious as. I just had to spray them with some mosquito spray because there was an ant nest here. And this is where I wanted to dig, and they just bite the hell out of you. I've probably got about 5 or 6 bites in my leg, but just here is where I just found that the Yo-Yo, Coca-Cola one. What? Oh, is it? Yes, it is. Oh yeah, we'll do a live dig here.
Holbrooks.
Oh yeah. Mate Pete has found a Holbrooks in stopper. Guess he'll be keeping that. Throw that up in his little pile, even though he hit a rock with it. Alright, Pete just broke that bottle. For some reason, I don't know. He's just aggressive, I guess. Yeah. Too many broken ones, you reckon?
This is the new dig. All this will be covered in. When we leave, Pete's digging the china. Find a lot of broken china, but yeah. Getting pretty big out here. Got little blog tops, lots of Campbelltowns, Parramattas, Campbelltown, Blues. Get the next broken off. But yeah. Digging here. He's enjoying himself. I'll let you know when I come up with a good live dig. These spots to do all around these spots. That's where I want to get underneath this tree. I was going to start up there, but I started down here and been finding good stuff, so just staying here.
Just found a lipstick. Pete said he wants it. He's just throwing stuff at me. But yeah, that's a lipstick. Keep that. A lot of metal detectors would like stuff like that. Guarantee that's a flat word in there. Yep, found a funnel web, eh? See this here? That's Australia's deadliest snake, spider. You just see him in the background there. He'll probably come out in a second. Probably just don't want to get bitten by him. None of that. I found a military button under it. Look at that. He's guarding that one. Alright. Look at that. There's no writing on it. But I might keep it. For some reason. Put that up there with the lipstick. That's why he's not coming out at the moment. I did know that in here was going to hold it, so I'll just go from the top and then he'll come out. What's these? That's his nest there. He'll come out in a second. Alright, don't mind that. That's just Pete flopping Duskin. Yeah. This is a real big. Oh, he's even got. Actually, there he is. Got the size of him. They got like a 2 centimeter. That's a big female. Yeah, one of the deadliest spiders in the world. And they're really aggressive, very territorial. They'll arc their 2 legs up. No, it's definitely what's name. Yeah, but that's the spot of it.
So that's not really actually
still, yeah, it's still lethargic, but you can tell, see the little things there. Little things just there. These things?
Yep.
Ooh. What? Take your glove off. Take your glove off.
No, take a photo. No. Relocate it.
Put your finger on it, bro. Press your finger on, put your finger on the spotter.
No,
like on the screen.
Oh, right.
So it focuses on that. There you go. Dick. I'm not putting it on. Hey? Oh, the bug I've dug up. Alright, this has to be old. It's bubble here. And it looks like a bloody bovril. Bloody hell. Alright, well, it is old. Old-ish. Yeah, not exciting. It's more than the one I got before. That's good. Two blue bottles out of the hole. Nice, it's got hallmarks as well. I think cut off at the top, tip. Alright, me and Peter are just going to swap spots for a bit. Nah, it's alright, man. Because I reckon I have. Look at that. Oh, what are they called again? Inkwell, yeah, but what type of inkwell? Inklet well.
Another blue bottle. This one's different too because it doesn't have the poison on it. Let's turn that. I think I'm right, this bloke. That's the other blue bottle that he's found. I think I'm right, that's alright for today. We have pulled out three different blue bottles. We'll be happy with that. Yeah, I haven't found very much. Alright, just come across this. Some old teeth. Foxes. Yeah, that's a strange find I never thought I was going to find. And I found a glass eye before too. No idea what happened to that. Yeah, some false teeth.
Oh! Just found a padlock. Pretty well and truly rusted, but put that there with my clock that I found. That I probably won't take. Probably won't take any of them. There? Ooh, yeah, that's a cod.
JPS Sutton.
That would have been right. This one looks pretty like it would have been in good condition. But like it's got it broken on the bottom, but like still has the paper on the top.
Paper or is it the
Well, that fucking aluminium stuff or whatever it is.
Lead.
Oh no, fuck, that's nice, man.
Alright.
Yeah. The red light's gone?
Yeah,
yeah, Pete just pulled that out. Anyone know what that is? I'm saying a perfume or something. That's awesome, cork top. Just having a slow dig, come across this little doodad. Not too sure what it is. Look at that. Old kerosene lantern. Don't think it's in working order, but the vase will turn. Yeah, if you build it, they'll come. Yeah, might keep that. Yeah, or something. I can't read it. I'll clean that up.
These are the stuff we're taking home. I've got me two lipsticks, a button. I probably won't take that home. It's an old clock. That can stay there. Old yo-yo. The kerosene. Dials, an old clock, an old padlock, this is Pete's inkwell, my teeth, two forks there, there's three blue bottles, some cork stops, some other cork stop bottles, but they'll be going to his kids. Yep, a broken Campbelltown cod bottle. Bit of a shame. And yeah, some white glass and a toothpaste lid. Yeah, that's about it that we're taking.
It's not too bad, we did dig a fair bit of
it. Oh yeah, these are some of the broken bottles that we pulled out of it. They're broken Parramatta bottles. More stoneware. That's a broken Melbourne bottle. A whole heap of cods, all broken. They're all local ones too. That's what's been good about this dump. That's all been locals. Yeah. Oh, except for that Melbourne bottle. Even got a. That's a blob top there.
But yeah, we have come across a lot of stuff, a lot of China,
like a little China ware and stuff like that. And
yeah, but all that's all going to get put back in there.